Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Soundara Raj. I'm happy to interact with you all through this video. In this video, I'm going to detail a concept titled Marketing Channel Conflicts. These are all a few details related to my career. After you watch the full video, if you really like the video and find it beneficial to you, give a like to the video and do subscribe my channel so that you will get the updates of my future videos. Channel conflicts. Introduction. Even though a manufacturer's channel design is well done, there will be some conflict among the channel members because of the differences in their objectives and perceptions of them. Certainly, we could evidence disagreements between the channel members, probably at the same level of the channel are at different levels of the same channel due to varied objectives what they have and also the varied perceptions of the channel members towards their roles and activities. Meaning and definition. Let's look at the definition given by Philip Kotler for the channel conflict. Channel conflict refers to the disagreement among the marketing channel members on goals and roles. Who should do what and for what rewards? This is a problem for the channel conflict among the members of the same channel. Disagreement among the marketing channel members on what? On the goals, on their objectives, and also the roles expected of them. When they have misconceived roles they should play in the channel of distribution for a company, they tend to have disagreement on their roles as well as their goals. And more specifically, the disagreement would be on who should do what every channel member is expected of in their way to move the product from the point of production to the point of consumption, and also in relation to the activities they should perform in promoting the product, in sharing the profitability, in sharing the territories. So on the issue of who should do what and for what rewards. These are all the fundamental issues for having disagreement between the channel members. There are two types of conflicts. One is horizontal conflict and the other one is vertical conflict. Horizontal conflict occurs among the firms or organizations at the same level of the channel. Might be conflicts between the dealers, or you can say in the next level, conflicts among the wholesalers or conflicts among the retailers, like that. So disagreement in the roles and rewards between the channel members at the same level refers to horizontal conflict. Vertical conflict occurs among the firms between different levels of the same channel. Might be like conflict between a wholesaler and retailer. That's a good example because they belong to two different levels in the same channel. If there is a disagreement between the firms belong to two different levels in the same channel, it refers to vertical conflict. The conflicts between the channel members can damage the channel's performance. When the channel members have disagreement with one another in their role, in their rewards, in their activities, in sharing boundaries or territories, definitely it is going to eventually damage the performance of the entire channel. Even if 5% of the channel intermediaries in a given channel have issues or conflicts with the remaining, definitely the contribution done by the 95% as expected of them is going to become waste. Marketers should periodically conduct formal or informal discussions with them to assess the areas or sources of conflicts. So periodical review by the marketers to be done with the channel intermediaries to assess the source of conflicts and put up the conflicts in the beginning itself. And this is what the suggestion given by marketing experts. Let us have a look at the sources of conflicts and their examples. Differences in objectives. That's the first source of conflict. What is a good example for it? Manufacturers want long-term profitability, but middlemen prefer short-term profitability. Obviously, as companies, they are looking for long-term profitability through a product, through a brand. Whereas the intermediaries, they don't have that much tolerance. They are looking for short-term profitability through the product they deal with. This is the first source of conflict between the manufacturers and the channel intermediaries. The second source of conflict is dealings with customers. The intermediaries feel that they are cheated by the manufacturers because the manufacturers want to serve a large group of customers, but they give the intermediaries a chance to serve a small group of customers in a smaller territory. This is a feeling or perception of the intermediaries. This is the second source of conflict. The third one is about differences in interest. The manufacturer feels that the intermediaries are not giving attention to the particular firm's products. The middlemen are interested in products that are fast moving or having higher margin for them. Obviously, the intermediaries will be interested in stocking the products of the company which are fast moving. See, among 10 products that are marketed by a company, say 8 could be fast moving, whereas the remaining 2 may not be moving well. Might be the 2 products are there in the introductory stage, or the 2 products are there in their declining stage in the product life cycle, like that. Or the market is not performing well for those 2 products in general. It's not only for this company, for all the companies that are there in the 2 products market. So obviously, they will be dull moving products. They will not be concentrated by the channel intermediaries because they are looking for short-term profitability. This is another source of disagreement or conflict between the manufacturers and the channel intermediaries. Differences in perceptions. The manufacturer wants the intermediary to carry a higher inventory in anticipating a good demand for the inventory in the near future. But whereas the intermediary does not share this optimism. Only when the demand comes in front of them for a product, the intermediaries will go to request the manufacturers to supply the stock. This is the issue. The next source of conflict is compensation. The intermediaries feel that the commission percentage offered by the manufacturers is not adequate, but the manufacturer thinks otherwise. So in sharing the profitability, they can have disagreement. The last one is about unclear territory. The unclear territory between the intermediaries results in competition among the firm's intermediaries to secure business from the same customers. When the boundary or the territory for each dealer is not clearly defined by the manufacturer, obviously, the intermediaries, they try to compete with one another. They step into the market of others, in the perception of others, to sell away the products to the customers belong to other territory. So this could be the feeling of one another. This is an important source of conflict among the channel intermediaries of a particular firm. How to resolve these conflicts? The channel conflicts can be controlled or managed in several ways, including effective communication network between the channel intermediaries and the companies. Joint goal setting. The company should take responsibility in organizing meetings with all channel intermediaries and clearly define about their territory, what roles expected of every one of them belong to different levels of the channel or in the same level of the channel, like that. So they have to set goals jointly. Diplomacy. Through diplomacy, the companies, the marketers can resolve conflicts among the intermediaries or conflicts between the intermediaries and the marketers. Mediation. Through the mediation of a third party or someone who is capable of resolving the conflict between the channel members, it could also be solved. Arbitration is another way of resolving channel conflict between the channel members. Thanks for watching this video. I hope I have explained the concept in a clear way up to your level of understanding. Thanks for your time. I'll meet you in another video. Bye for now, everyone.